We had four pigs constructed for the film from a prop house in Toronto. It was kind of not a last minute decision, but a quick decision, and they had about 2 weeks to turn.
16-day turnaround?
About that.
16-day turnaround for four sculpted pigs, all individually designed, is an amazing feat.
The pigs were all made out of foam rubber and latex with their entrails hanging out the front. And I know that our special effects team had a heck of a time mixing up enough blood and guts and pig entrails to really make it look effective.
What happens when Dave Hackle comes to you and says, I need two pigs?
Well, Dave Hackle says he needs four pigs, and we say, how, where, and why? And he says, hung up in a warehouse on meat hooks. And so we know what it looks like when you butcher a pig for real, and we take it from there.
Normally a pig is hanging face down, but because we wanted to really have the horror of their face, you know, the expressions on their face, you can see how horrific this one is over here. We wanted to see eyes with maggots all in the eye socket, and they just became a little more horrific when they were upright and their entrails were hanging out. And you can see deep inside these carcasses too, which is really nice.
So anytime, turn it towards the light.
Yeah.
Anytime light hits them, you know, see, I don't know if you can see in there, but the light coming through the side will just be so nice. And
this pig took massive trauma, as you see. We've actually sent him out.
He's gone out for repairs a few times. Well, yeah, a few times.
He took a big cut across the neck here.
So now he's got the Bubblicious look.
Yeah, he's
chewed bubblegum.
The construction of the pigs was incredible, but just the amount of abuse that they were taking during shooting was unbelievable. Mm-hmm. And they were designed to do that, but we really put them through the test here, so.
Yeah, they're still sticky.
They're still sticky. This was one of the maggot pigs. This was all filled with maggots, and it's still kind of, if you licked it, it would taste like honey. And maggots. Do you want maggots for the
yes,
the pigs?
Yes, but again, just get a cup full of maggots, and they're only going to be used for close-ups.
One of my favorite times on making Saw 3 was Darren had this crazy idea, let's get maggots and put them on the pigs as they come out, and we'll do a close-up, and there'll be all these maggots all over the pigs, and great, that's great. And so we got maggots, and we're rushing around like crazy trying to get that scene, and we're running out of time, and we had to do so many things so quickly, and Mario, my assistant, and I are up on the meat grinder set, and we got a box of mealworm maggots, and we're giving us no time to get this set up, and we're just like slapping honey all over these huge rotting latex pig carcasses, and we're just taking handfuls of maggots and just sticking them to the side of the pigs frantically, and then we had to roll the chain back, so we had to do one pig, stick maggots all over it, roll it back, and to get another pig and stick maggots all over it, and the maggots were falling all over us, the maggots were falling all over the people below. The guys that were running the chain didn't have any, like, they didn't have rubber gloves like we did, because we just ran into it so fast. So they're back there, they're pulling these big maggot-covered pigs back, and we're rolling on it, and maggots are going everywhere. The set was covered in maggots, and it was just absolute mayhem, but it was a lot of fun.
Our maggots were sterilized maggots, so that if someone by some strange chance had one get in their mouth or anywhere else, and they were to consume the thing, it was completely edible, like edible maggots.